Impact is integral to everything that Caspian does. But not everybody in the Caspian team has an opportunity to see the achievements on the ground. Therefore, we decided that the Team Caspian should have an opportunity to visit Kalahandi in Orissa and see for themselves what happens on the ground based on the work they do at their office in Hyderabad. We also took this opportunity to visit a few rural schools and interact with institutions like the village panchayat to know more about rural India.
I have never visited this part of Orissa before, these particular districts, so I'm really looking forward to interacting with people there. I think we'll get to learn a lot about rural institutions and livelihoods. I am trying my best not to have any preconceived notions about the place, but of course I expect that people will have very grueling lives.
I will be visiting a village for the first time, so I don't want to make any assumptions right now. However, I do expect that the infrastructure will be limited, which will make people's life difficult. I plan to keenly observe everything to get a real picture of life there.
So long-term capital gains tax on it.
We worked on Adhikar, no?
We worked.
So he's the founder of Adhikar, Amin. So we just met him, he was having breakfast in the hotel, so... He'll become a Equita, so... But yeah. 1 lakh members, 1.5 lakh members. They feel that is...
good. That is all they want to reach.
Farming, they should raise their hands.
Acha ke ke bhagu chha je tamar pila chua man chas
korbe chas ke 7-8 taka
alternate bhi batao
only chas nahi only nahi
na mai se kore bele
kete khali chas kor pila ke chasi banabar log je 7-8 taka se tar pila chok chasi korbo seta prachar
hat uta
only
chas ha thora to bata
only chasi
फिर खाना खा के फिर वापस आएंगे फिर यहीं पे रहेंगे और आपको यूनिफॉर्म कौन देता है ये जो स्कूल का ड्रेस है क्या है अरे स्कूल का ड्रेस कौन दिया आप गुड़िया ज्यादा अच्छा लगता है आप बड़े होके क्या करेंगे आप क्या बनोगे बड़े होकर के पुलिस बनेंगे और आप क्या करेंगे बड़े होके
लेक्चर यही गांव में होगा नहीं तो दूसरे गांव में
नहीं दूसरे गांव में दूसरे गांव में जाके पढ़ेंगे क्यों अपने स्कूल में पढ़ाना नहीं चाहिए
दूसरे गांव में
शादी जाएगा तो
कॉलेज
में कॉलेज नहीं होगा ना अब गांव में होगा तो गांव में
जब तक आप पीछे पड़े तब तक ये कॉलेज में गांव में कॉलेज हो जाएगा ना
बता
दे और आप क्या करेंगे
ऐसे बोलता है
रो रो आना पड़ेगा दो बात
सारे चलो पढ़ाई करो थैंक यू चलो बाय
बीस लाख देना चाहते हैं कि ओके ये हम वो इन्वेस्ट करेंगे और थोड़ा ज़मीन लेंगे उससे वो हम नहीं कर पा रहे हैं क्योंकि फार्मर्स पूरा एंड ऑफ द सीज़न में पैसा पूरा बांट देते हैं वो कंपनी में कोई पैसा छोड़ते नहीं उसका कुछ कर सकते हैं हम मतलब आप ऐसा सोचे तो हम और सुविधा कर सकते हैं
ଆଜ୍ଞା କହୁଛନ୍ ଯେ ଏବେ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସର୍ କମ୍ପାନୀକେ ବି ସେମାନେ ଡାଇରେକ୍ଟ ଲୋନ୍ ଦେବାର କାହିଁ ଚିନ୍ତା କରୁଛନ୍ ଯଦି ଲୋନ୍ ଦେଲେ ଏବେ ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସର୍ କମ୍ପାନୀ ତମର ପ୍ରଡ୍ୟୁସର୍ କମ୍ପାନୀ କାଣା କରୁଛେ ଏବେ ଯେନ୍ତା ମାତୃଭୂମି ତମର କପା କିଣୁଛେ ଚାଷୀଟା ସେମାନେ ଯେନ୍ ପଇସା ଦେଇଥିବେ ସେତିକି ପଇସା ଚାଷୀକେ ତମେ ଦେଇ ଦେଉଛ କମ୍ପାନୀ ପାଇଁ କିଛି ନାହିଁ ନା ତ ସେଟା କେନ୍ତା କଲେ ତମର ପାଖେ ପଇସା ରହିବ ସେମାନେ ଅଧିକା ପଇସା
ଅଗଲେ ସାଲ ଆମେ ଜ୍ୟାଦା ପଇସା ନେଇ ଦେଖ ସକେ କ୍ୟୁକି ଓ କମ୍ପାନୀ କା ଜୋ ହେ 1 ଲାଖ ହେ ଓହି 1 ଲାଖ ହି ହେ अब पूरा प्रॉफिट डिस्ट्रीब्यूट हो जाता है और डिस्ट्रीब्यूट क्यों होता है मतलब आपको पैसा चाहिए आप खेती किए उसका प्रॉफिट आपको चाहिए, इसका मतलब इसका ऐसा कुछ सॉल्यूशन निकाल सकते हैं क्या? हमारे पास सॉल्यूशन नहीं है, इसलिए आपसे पूछ रहे हैं।
नहीं होगा सर, सॉल्यूशन होगा, आप जो बोल रहे हैं ना वो सॉल्यूशन होगा। देखिए जो प्रोड्यूसर कंपनी है तो हम लोग सब पैसा निकल के, आप लोग बोल रहे हैं पैसा निकल के ले रहे हैं, कंपनी में कुछ
पैसा छोड़ते नहीं,
छोड़ते नहीं, तो कुछ कुछ हम बैलेंस रखेंगे तो कंपनी का भी अकाउंट में कुछ पैसा बचेगा, जैसे कि हम बैंक में।
नहीं अभी फार्मर्स ऐसा बोलते हैं लेकिन वो करते नहीं।
हाँ नहीं वो तो आप बोले सही, लेकिन हमारा आपका जो सोच भी हम भी सोचते हैं, तो कुछ कुछ पैसा हम छोड़ देते हैं, कुछ अकाउंट में बैलेंस कंपनी का अकाउंट में बैलेंस आ जाएगा तो हम जैसे कि बैंक पे भरोसा करते हैं चाहे खेती के टाइम में, तो हम उधर भी कुछ कंपनी से लेके कुछ इंटरेस्ट ज़्यादा कम इंटरेस्ट भी देके कंपनी
थोड़ा थोड़ा वो ऐसा होता है। अभी अभी जो होता है ऐसी नहीं होता था, अभी जो ये ऑर्गेनिक फार्मर के लिए वो चेतना जो आया जिस दिन से, इस दिन हमारा मार्केट भी ठीक हुआ है। एक बात द्वितीय बार हमारे चास करने के लिए भी उनका दिमाग से किया है, ये बताता है ऐसी करता है ऑर्गेनिक फार्मर के लिए, ऑर्गेनिक फार्मर में कितने आयदे होता है ये सब हमको चेतना मालूम कर दिया है।
आप पहले से कपास ही करते थे या कोई दूसरा?
नहीं कपास करते थे, पेड़ी करते थे, डेढ़ ग्राम
जो फड़र करके कुछ डायरी कर सकता है।
और ये पूरा कितने एकड़?
2.25 एकड़।
ओके,
तो इतना सारे चीज हम इधर किए हैं इस साल, तो अभी अंदर में जाके देखना।
आई हैड अ ग्रेट लर्निंग एक्सपीरियंस, वी गॉट द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू इंटरेक्ट विद कम्युनिटीज हु वुड अदरवाइज बी वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर अस टू रीच। अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल रियली ओपनड अप टू अस एंड दे शेयर्ड अ लॉट अबाउट देयर लाइव्स, देयर रूटीन, देयर प्रोग्रेस, देयर चैलेंजेस। सो द ट्रिप रिमाइंडेड मी दैट रूरल इंडिया ऑफ कोर्स इज नॉट अ होमोजिनस मास, वी मेट डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ पीपल, सम ऑफ देम वर वेरी कंटेंट विद देयर लाइव्स, whereas others wanted to bring some major change in their lives and had very different aspirations. For us investors or as urban people in general, it may be well and good that we have notions such as creating an impact or trying to change rural India, but the first and most basic question of ours should be what are the people who live there actually like? What do they want? And of course, somewhere we know this, but it's good to be reminded now and again. In addition, during the trip, one other very interesting aspect was the functioning of institutions on the ground, be it SHGs, cooperatives, farmer groups, panchayats. We got to see the kinds of conflicts they're managing, be it conflicts of resources or managing people's expectations, which was very interesting for me.
While I visited rural areas before as a part of my work or my own experimental learning, I had never visited a tribal village before. Apart from our scheduled visit to local SHGs, cooperatives or schools, we were keen to know and understand the lives of tribal villages and how they are different from other sections of the society. Clearly, tribal villages have their own unique culture, and one important thing which I noticed was that tribal village women are much more empowered within the families and have a larger say in the affairs of the family compared to the women of rest of the sections of the society. Another important thing which I noticed was the non-availability of irrigation facilities. Most of the farmers are restricted to only one crop cycle for the entire year. Projects initiated by Tata Trust such as DBI project certainly helps some villages to grow more than one crop. Government machineries have their own set of limitations, and I feel more and more corporate should come forward, especially in the education and education infrastructure space, which has the power to lift rural India to another level.
I went to Orissa with an open mind and curious heart to know how the rural India function, to see how families live in their day-to-day life, how they do agriculture, how the schooling is there, how is the status and what is the status of healthcare in India. When I came back, I was overwhelmed with the response of rural India, the way they conduct themselves. And it reminded me of Mahatma Gandhi, who once said that the real India lives in the villages. So I could very well say that the way villagers conduct themselves in rural India, the way they struggle in their day-to-day life, the way they explore and understand the government scheme and take benefit out of it is amazing. This trip helped me a lot to understand rural India.
In the villages, what I observed is the agriculture is their major source of livelihood. But people there are trying their best to diversify their income. They use SHGs and other organizations to create a supportive environment for themselves. The infrastructure and connectivity surpass my expectations. People there are aware about civic issues and they know which government schemes they should use which going to benefit them in the future. Overall, interacting with the communities and experiencing the rural life gave me an idea how difficult the life is there and how they can manage to be happy themselves.
So I had kept my expectations really low. We carried mosquito repellents, we carried drinking water, we carried dry snacks, because you probably expected that we're not going to get good quality food or even drinking water over there. But luckily when we reached there, it was a pretty good experience. The towns were recently developed, women were at the forefront. We spoke to a lot of women, we went to their cotton fields. They told us about their day-to-day activities, their involvement in self-help groups. And apparently, we came to know that self-help groups have really helped them in terms of establishing their financial independence and in general having a say in their household. So overall, I would say that it has been quite an enriching experience, and we would look forward to more of such experiences.